Damit ein herzliches Willkommen zu einem weiteren Part Let's Play Fake Grand Order. Ich bin es, euer Simofitz. Wir sind hier wieder in unserem Mörder-Mystery, wollen hier herausfinden, wer der Mörder ist und haben hier schon ein paar heiße Spuren. Und ich würde mal sagen, wir machen hier gleich weiter in Mörder-Ette Kokitsukan, Kapitel Nummer 5. Dürfte es sein, No Strange Foreigners Must Figure in the Story. Oh mein Gott, was ist jetzt schon wieder? What is it? Do you have any idea what time it is? I was having a really good dream, you know. Ja, denn beim letzten Mal haben wir erfahren, dass jemand hier die Hochzeit mehr oder weniger crashen will. Deswegen ist ja hier Morris jetzt erstmal verschwunden. Und ich denke mal, also wir haben jetzt erstmal angenommen, beziehungsweise Sherlock, dass das nächste Opfer die Wette Juliet hier sein könnte. Oh, thank goodness, you're right. You big dummy. You always overreact. But since I'm up now, why did you think I was going to die? Now I see. You think someone here wants to put an end to the engagement? I don't think there is anything to worry about, though. I mean, if our families don't join forces, then either we go down fighting each other or end up falling victim to some outside power. Everyone here knows that. That's why even Morris is going along with this. So, you don't think there'll be more murders? Und wo ist dann bitte Morris hin? Und wieso wurde Sherlock umgebracht? I don't think so anyway. I mean, what would be the point? But we can't rest easy just yet. We should go check on Chris too. Just be sure. Just give me a moment to freshen up. Genau, nämlich wenn Juliet nicht das Opfer ist, dann wäre natürlich die nächste logische Zielperson Chris.
Oh, morning. Were you two off it is so early? If you're here for breakfast, I'm afraid it isn't ready.
We just wanted to check in on Chris.
Man, what a lucky guy he is. I wish I had a beautiful girl to wake me up. Anyway, that works out nicely. I was just wondering when he'd getting up. I could use his help with some chores, but I didn't want to have to wake him up. Erstod. I mean, he is gonna be an important client of ours soon. Erstod.
Well then, let's all go wake him up together.
Erstod. Erstod.
I think this was his room, right? Good morning, Chris. Are you up yet?
Erstod, Mann. Wir wissen, alter Mann, wenn schon alle sagen, ja, jetzt gehen wir hin und alles ist so schön und ist wichtig. Ich weiß doch, dass tot ist.
Answer. Is Chris not a morning person or something?
That shouldn't be an issue. He's been trained to wake up if he hears anything suspicious.
That's strange. Then why would... Wait. Why is this door unlocked?
Damn. Oh. He's dead. Er hat mit seinem Blut noch was geschrieben. M-O-R. Morris.
Huh? Chris? No. He can't be.
He's definitely gone. His body's already cold. I guess he died sometime around midnight. I go get Dr. Hoffron. I want to get his autopsy over and done with before everyone else shows up.
Alright, I just did a quick autopsy. I didn't see any major injuries, but I did find 3 small wounds. See that red spot on top of his hand? It's a puncture wound, like made by a needle. If the killer used a poison like, say, Wolfsbane, it would only take a single prick to paralyze the victim. This other red spot in his hand is likely a second needle prick, just to be certain he didn't survive.
Das bedeutet also, er wurde auch vergiftet, wie auch schon unser erstes Opfer.
At this point I can't say what kind of poison was used, but if 2 small wounds were enough to kill him, it must have been very strong stuff.
Then why does he have a third wound?
I don't believe it's directly connected to his stuff. Take a look at the tip of his left index finger.
It looks like there's a little blood on it. Where did that injury come from?
It would seem he bit his finger himself, so as to use his blood to write a message on the floor.
I think it says more.
That's what it looks to me. Though I don't know what it could mean.
Also,
Nummer 1. Natürlich hat er hier versucht, den Namen seines Mörders zu schreiben. Das ist klar. Nummer 2. In 99% aller Fälle ist es, wenn jemand versucht, mit seinen letzten Kräften noch was noch zu schreiben, dass der Mörder das ja merkt. Ich meine, wenn der da so was hinmalt, wenn er da vergiftet ist, glaube ich, ist das kein Zufall. Ich weiß es nicht. Vielleicht denke ich dazu weiter, aber...
Well, Mord is French for death, but I can't imagine why he would write that while he was dying.
Vielleicht hat er auch Mord geschrieben? Nee, Deutsch gibt's nicht. Deutsch gibt's nicht.
More, I wonder if...
What is it, Wu?
Nothing, just thinking out loud. Chris can hold his own in a fight. He'd never let someone else get better of him that easily.
Then assume his was a fight. What if he merely shook the killer's hand? If our culprit had planned to a poison needle, or the like, a simple handshake could be fatal.
Well, it might be kind of rude of me to ask, but...
What is it? Go ahead, I won't be offended. Wo warst du?
Well, whoever killed Chris must have been someone he knew well enough to let his guard down, right? On top of that, someone inexperienced enough to kill cleanly and quietly. You're the first one who came to mind.
Ha, now I gotcha. You're not wrong. Well, let me show you something else then.
Up. Huh? How did you do that?
It's an illusion. All I'm doing is moving fast enough that you can only see the afterimage. Das kann doch, das... Ich habe letztens Hunter x Hunter angeschaut und da konnte der Kilia konnte das auch.
I have to move this fast if I'm going to see the everyone needs.
If you can do that, what can't you do?
Aber was, also, wenn der das macht, wieso soll das jetzt heißen, dass er nicht der Mörder ist?
Ah, it's true, there are pretty much nothing I can't do. I probably shouldn't say this in front of guests, but if I wanted to, I could kill everyone here in about the time I'd take you to snap your fingers.
Oh my.
Oh, but don't worry. I wouldn't actually do that. I gave up the assassination business a long time ago.
Du sprichst gerade nicht für dich. Ich habe die Möglichkeit, euch alle zu töten. Chris hat mir vertraut. Ich bin so mächtig, dass ich, ich war früher ein super Assassine und habe hier 100.000 Menschen getötet.
But I certainly say this much. I didn't kill Chris. If I was gonna kill him, I wouldn't have done it like this. Giving him time to write their message is an amateur move.
Good point. I believe you, Wu.
Thanks, Miss Juliet. Huh, looks like Chris left another message. Take a look at this.
A pocket watch. It looks pretty old.
It is. Sis gave it to me. He polished it every day. Always made sure it was in good working order, too. It stopped at 11:25, though. And the glass is cracked. It looks like it's broken. Right. Chris took really good care of it. So there's no chance of it just having randomly broken last night. Especially since it was built to last. I did bet anything he broke it himself on purpose. To tell whoever found him what time he met with the killer? Exactly.
So, that would mean he met the killer in his room a little before F25 last night.
That'd be my guess. If the killer had killed him somewhere else and moved his body here, I'd have noticed that happening. That will make everyone's alibis important to figuring out who our killer is. For my part, I was playing poker with Aaron, Adamska and Anne last night. We started around 10 o'clock and kept going until about 3 in the morning. We did take a few short breaks, but nobody left the room for long. It was a damn good game. I stuck around to watch until midnight myself. I haven't seen Sis that fired up in a long time.
I was in my room with my sister around that time last night. Does that count even though we're family?
Counts in my book. And I'm not just saying that because you believed me when I say I didn't kill Chris. You really seem to be telling the truth.
Das Ding ist, was ist unser Alibi? Ich weiß ja nicht, was passiert, während wir hier schlafen.
Oh, come on, to think of it. You've got an alibi for the time of night too, Maxi.
Was? Hab ich?
You were already completely passed out. Hä? Wo weißt du das? Oh, that's easy. Our poker game was in the room next to yours. Hard not to hear you snoring. But I'll leave the alibi stuff up to you. You're the detective now, right?
Zum Glück ist niemand draufgekommen, dass ich mein Schnarchen vorher aufgenommen habe und es abgespielt habe.
I hate thinking up alibis and that sort of thing.
You do?
I know I said there's nothing I can do, but that's not strictly true. I'm useless with riddles. All the things I can do, and none of it's gonna help Chris now. Please, Maxie. I've gotta find whoever did this to him. I have to sleep on it. I'll give it my best shot. Good choice of words. I have every confidence in you. Anyway, enough chit-chat. We should run up and tell them what happened.
Irgendwie ist keiner so richtig betroffen, dass Chris gestorben ist. Das Ding ist, also es ist jetzt die Alibi-Jagd. Wenn wir die jetzt schon mal alle ausgeschlossen haben, dann haben wir die beiden Schwestern ausgeschlagen. Ja, also eigentlich jetzt sind jetzt eher am verdächtigsten, ne? Muss ich jetzt sagen. Morris, klar, weil er hat's hingeschrieben, keiner weiß, wo Morris ist. Und zum anderen haben wir hier natürlich die Kinder, Kane und Laurie. Wartet. Nee, ich dachte, das ist so dieser alte Trick, dass in Wahrheit ist es falsch rumgeschrieben. Aber Mor? War? Keine Ahnung, nein.
By the time we got to Chris' room, it was already too late. Oh no, poor Chris.
Where's Anne? I don't see her anywhere.
She's carrying Chris down to the basement, which is serving as our mortuary for now.
I guess she said she wanted to at least do that much for himself.
I see. Then Chris really is dead. And just when I'd named him my successor. What a terrible timing.
Why are you looking at me like that? You think I'm the one who killed him? Well, I didn't. I was putting Laurie to bed. You have to believe me.
Please calm down, Mr. Murphy.
Warte mal, jetzt muss ich hier nochmal hochgehen. Wer hat nochmal hier beim Poker gespielt? Das war jetzt nochmal hier. Ah, Leute, ich fühle mich hier richtig wie Detektiv Conan. Jetzt finde ich es natürlich nicht.
Aaron, Adamska und Anne. Das heißt, Dorothy hätte kein Alibi, Kane hätte keins, Laurie hätte keins, okay, das muss man zusammenziehen. Morris, klar. Grenzt die doch ein wenig ein.
As it turns out, Chris managed to write down more right before he died. He didn't get to finish his message, but it still seems more than likely that's a clue as who killed him. And there is someone whose name starts with more here. Is there?
More? You don't mean Morris?
I don't see how it could be anyone else.
So you're saying Morris killed Chris? Is that it?
I'm just saying it's possible. He might still be hiding out somewhere. I hope I haven't offended you.
Not at all. It's the best news I've heard since we left the strip. On the strip. As long as Morris is alive, the Garley family still has a bright future.
Bist du jetzt ganz behindert? Ich dachte, gerade wurde einer von deinen Söhnen umgebracht und es ist dir wurscht.
I was listening, Morris. Come out now. And I hire you the best lawyer money can buy.
Honey, he's taking this pretty hard, isn't he?
At any rate, we are going to start running things around here to ensure there aren't any more mistakes. That doesn't mean we are going to start looking you up in your rooms or anything. But if you want to stay alive, I'm going to ask that you follow our instructions as much as possible.
Hey, Maxie, please don't die, okay?
Ich tue mein Bestes. Ich tue mein Bestes.
Was hat sie denn da an? Uh-huh.
Oh, hello, Maxie.
Can I ask you why you're dressed like that? Ist ganz normal.
I just wanted to go for a little swim, since we came all the way to this lovely resort and all. I doubt we will approve though, so I don't know what I'm going to do.
By the way, did anything unusual happen around bedtime last night, Miss Violet?
Sie hat nämlich eigentlich doch auch kein Alibi gehabt.
Miss Violet? Well, that's a strange question. No. Mother turned in early last night. I think it must have been around 10, maybe 11. I'm sorry, I don't remember the exact time. Oh, I just had a lovely idea. We could all go for a swim. That way, Wu could still keep an eye on us. I go suggest it to him right now. I hope you can join us, Maxie.
Okay. Nehmen wir natürlich ein. Nehmen wir natürlich an. Können wir da wieder stehen?
I'm glad we could come to an arrangement.
Likewise. I too would be tremendously grateful for such a resolution. Thank you for coming too with me. Laurel muss jetzt heiraten.
Ah, it's you. Thank you for being such a good friend to Juliet. You must think I'm a terrible excuse for a father, offering my own daughter in a political marriage. I'm sure you have your reason. It's okay. It's the truth. And while we're on the subject, I'll admit I'm a terrible leader too. I'm a coward. But it's because I'm a coward that I can tell which way the wind is blowing. I saw that if I didn't do something, the Violet family would have no future whatsoever. If we didn't suffer heavy losses in an all-out war with the Goldie family, we would only end up falling prey to the powerful enemy from elsewhere. That's why I came to the conclusion that an alliance with the Goldie family was our only option for survival. I never had anything going for me besides my family name. I was never cut out for this world. I was just lucky enough to receive an offer for an arrangement marriage with the Violet family's daughter. I was inexorated by her beauty at first sight, and it wasn't long until we were married. Aha! Also Ademska. Das ist in Wahrheit gar nicht ein Mitglied der Violet Familie, sondern Eva ist in Wahrheit die Violet, also die, die hier zu dem Mafia-Clan, wie auch immer, gehört. I thought there was nothing I couldn't do as long as it would make her happy. That was what let me do my best at a job that was frankly beyond me for the next 20 years. But now, I'm the head of the whole Violet family. I have to think about what's best for my children and for my subordinates. My wife was against this idea, but for once I went against her wishes, especially since Juliet agreed to ahead with it.
Hä? Die sah jetzt aber ehrlich gesagt nicht so glücklich aus über die Heirat. Das. Leute, ist das richtig? Rajbi, did she?
You really do know her well. I'm actually relieved. As it turns out, Dorothy just came out with an interesting proposition. If Aaron agrees to it, it should solve all our problems. But then, I guess there isn't much point in telling you about this. Just forget I said anything. The point is, if all goes well, Juliet will be free. I'm sure you want that just as much as I do. Laurie und Kane heiraten. Now, if you excuse me, I need to think of a way to convince Aaron.
There you are. Where have you been all this time?
I'm just gathering information.
Detective Maxi.
Okay. Well, you shouldn't have to do that alone. I'll go with you.
Miss Juliet does a convincing job of playing stoic, but she was really worried about you.
You didn't need to tell him that.
Oh, I just remembered Miss Eva suggested we all go to the beach after we had lunch.
Well, I guess we could use a breather, given the circumstances.
I go ahead and whip something up for lunch now. I should fall asleep and go back to Caldea for a bit.
Good plan.
Hey, you're looking kind of drowsy. Go ahead and catch some if you want. I'll make sure you wake you up. Feel free to reach out on that sofa over there.
So mitten in der Halle, wo jeder uns ermorden kann.
Welcome back, Senpai. What happened over there? Chris, too? That's awful.
What is it, Holmes? Oh, it is nothing of importance. I was just thinking about what these alibis could mean.
Oh, do you stop beating around the bush, would you? If you don't know the answer, just say so. Well, at least we finally found a way to get you to pipe down. By the way, is this Wu person foreign?
Come to think of it, I think one of the commitments in Nox Decalogues was no mysterious foreigner must figure into the story. Does that have anything to do with this case? This may be hard for you to believe, having grown up in this modern era. But during the golden age of detective fiction, some people believed quite firmly that foreigners held mysterious powers.
I have no way of knowing what Nox may have truly meant by that maxim, but thinking conventionally, I would think it means to not rely on beings with unknown abilities, foreign or otherwise, to connect your story's dots.
In that sense, we can take Wu at his word and strike him from the list of suspects. No bland, uninspired case where just about anything goes or would ever fall into the lap of a detective such as myself. That's true. A mysterious relying on cheap tricks and bizarre gimmicks isn't really something anyone would enjoy solving, is it?
That will
say that I had a number of foreign connections myself. Would you mind bragging about your connection in the East End another time? At any rate, I'd like to focus on Chris' dying message.
You mean the Moor? He wrote it in his own blood.
Indeed, I can certainly understand wishing to leave behind an accusation of one's killer once death is certain. But we don't. But we do not yet have enough information to be certain that Morris is what he meant to write. Though it is only 6 letters, that may have been too much to write out while he was on death's door.
Das ist ja das Nächste. Wenn du kurz davor bist zu sterben, glaube ich, hast du jetzt auch nicht die Kraft, da wirklich das zu malen. Vielleicht wollte er auch was anderes schreiben.
I guess so. I know if I was a murder victim, I might try to write some hint as the killer's identity. Does that mean you've already figured out what the message really means, Holmes?
I have a hypothesis, but there would be little point in voicing it now.
Would that be because your lack of confidence in it, or because of what you suspect still lies ahead?
Interpret it as you like. I merely want to avoid coloring our impressions before we have all the data we need to resolve this case. My job is to reveal the truth, after all, so where possible, I like to deal strictly in facts. Besides, the only one who truly needs to know how valid my deductions are at any given point in time is myself.
There you see, this is exactly why I can't stand detectives. You care more about who you plan to solve their case, and then you do well-being of the people fearing for their lives. I dare see if anyone here is a cold-hearted villain, it is you, not I.
Need I remind you, Professor, I was never the architect of any mysteries of my own, particularly not any involving murder.
There's actually one other thing I've been wondering about. What could Dorothy have proposed to Adamska?
Oh, that mystery is not nearly so difficult. One simply need consider the difficult position Dorothy's in, and her temperate nature to arrive at the answer. Though, of course, it will mean little if Aaron refused to go along.
I'm getting sleepy.
Ah, it would seem we are once more out of time. Very well, one last word of advice. Now that Chris is dead, the game is well and truly afoot. Do not let your guard down.
Ha, und wir stehen eigentlich vor noch mehr Mysterien als am letzten Part. Chris ist tot. Alle haben fast ein wasserdichtes Alibi. Wie gesagt, das, was die hier ausgemacht haben, das war sicher nochmal eine neue Heirat. Das sollte klar sein. Das war wahrscheinlich zwischen Kane und Laurie, die verstehen sich doch so gut. Doch die Frage ist natürlich immer noch, wer ist der Mörder? Wer könnte verantwortlich sein für den Tod von Chris? Ich denke, das ist das, was wir nun weiter versuchen herauszufinden. Doch davor machen wir nun erstmal einen kleinen Cut und beim nächsten Mal geht's weiter mit Let's Play Fate Grand Order. Mörder at Kogetsu. Bis zum nächsten Mal. Ciao.